Paul? Yes, Paul's going to give us an Egyptian song.
I could not find a better topic to talk about, better than talking about the Assemblies of God Church in Egypt. By the time I'm getting...
We do have Ravi, who is going to share different. So here we go, Ravi. Over to you.
How you doing? My name is Ravinesh Kumar. You can call me Ravi. I came from Fiji in 1989, and I had my whole family here. Family of eight. And out of them, only two are saved, but I pray for them, and the Lord will bring them in His own will. First of all, I'd like to thank Conrad for giving me the opportunity tonight to share with you my testimony. I'd like to say that it's so wonderful to see Pastor Bruce here tonight. I went up there I come from a Hindu background. I was lost, totally lost then, what happened?
Say something. Say hi.
Hello.
Shireen's going to share. My notes say it is a Sri Lankan solo.
And rain blew and beat upon that house, but it did not fall. No matter what they do, no matter what they teach us, what we believe is true. No matter what they call us, can't deny what I believe. I can't be one and not. No matter what, no, no matter what, no, no matter.
We have our final item. My sheet says it's Morris and the Multicultural Choir.
Thank you.
Jr.
What should I say, the pillar of this group, the leader of this group, the person who does all the work, who sends me the phone. God bless you, and look at how God's using you there, Brother Conrad.
Thank you very much. I'm sure you enjoyed the evening. If you're not, please raise your hand and come and pray. I just wonder how heaven will be, how we will look in heaven. What we will be dressing, what language we will be speaking, who will be leading praise and worship in heaven, who knows, maybe the Sri Lankans, maybe the Praise God. Thank God, you may come from different countries, the Lord has united us here as brothers and sisters in the Lord. Today we have so many visitors, distinguished guests, VIPs. Special welcome to our dear pastor, Pastor Bruce, son James, the next pastor of God's Church. Maji, thank you very much for coming. Just all those who have felt the very first time, could you just please raise your hand? We'd like to welcome you. Oh, praise Lord. Thank you for coming. I think with our survey, we have something from our team for coming. And as you know, so we are standing here. Just please, a few more minutes, and then we're going to have a lovely fellowship. And I just tell you, today is the last chapter, should I say, one section of our fellowship has been closed, because from henceforth we are shifting to our chapel at the Garden City Christian Church. We are going to meet every third Saturday commencing 16th of August. So the next meeting will be on the 16th of August, a Saturday, 4 o'clock, 4 to 6 at the Garden City Chapel. And this fellowship from August onwards is going to be completely different. It's going to be a time of a variety of programs. We're going to have a lovely present worship, testimony, Word of God, and also, just to spice our fellowship, we're going to have a cookery demonstration. So if you want to know what is a Sri Lankan pudding or a Fijian sweet or how you make an Indian cake, please come every third Saturday, August 16th, commencing in August. And having said that, I don't want to take much of Pastor Bruce's time, but I just want to introduce our team to the fellowship. So for Pastor Bruce, I just want you to meet our team. So if you could kindly come and stand here so that you could see our team. And also, I can just quickly give you the history of our fellowship. Actually, our fellowship started on the August, almost 2 years ago. We had a call from Albert and Lily. Albert and Lily, could you please stand? They were the initiator of the fellowship. A fellowship specifically among the Hare Christians. But thank God, the Lord had so many other ideas. As time went on, the Lord began to have so many curries and desserts, and here we have a beautiful fellowship of 21 different nationalities. The whole fellowship is planned as a team. We call it the A-Team. And I would like to meet the A-Team. We have David and Sulu. Just raise your hand. David Sulu. Then Joe and they are not here with us. Then we have Maurice and Roxana. Maurice and Jenny and Valerie. Thank you. And my wife and myself, we all work as a team, the A team, and we do a beautiful coordinated thing. In addition to the team, we have so many others in our fellowship who really inspire us. We have two ladies in our midst, and if someone is happy to live in Tanamara or if they live in Callumville, everyone in Tanamara and Calendar knows about Multicultural Fellowship because of these two ladies. One is Selvi. Selvi? Selvi, she really promotes our fellowship. They've got so many souls to our fellowship and also our church. And Pat, where's Patty? So many people to Garden City Christian Church, to our fellowship, a great soul winner. And we also have a couple who really intercede for each one of us here, for the pastors, for whatever we do, and that is Artha and Sarojini. They are our intercessors. They really pray for us. And actually then we have Paul Taylor who really helps us. Paul, Joe, Sherry, Joe Davita, and so many others really help us to build this fellowship. So having said that, Pastor, what you see here is a testimony of your vision the Lord has given you to build a fellowship like the first century Christian. And our mission is to take the love of Christ, especially to the Hindus and the Buddhists. After all, every sixth person on this planet is a Hindu or a Buddhist. So having said that, Pastor, you're welcome here. We are so happy to have you. Just feel at home. And please, take your time.
Thank you. Oh, that's very nice, and we appreciate those very kind words too. How are you tonight? Have you had a good week this week? Have you had lots of curry this week? I haven't heard that term before, curry Christians. So you're really on fire, in all respects. And your spirit and your body as well. I remember the first time I ever went to India, I stayed with some people there and I had curry for breakfast, for lunch, for dinner, the whole time I was there. When I came back, I said to my wife, I never want curry again. Didn't eat curry for 18 months after that. I couldn't even look at it. But it's really great to be with you tonight. We've actually tried for some time to get a date that I could be here. But because of a busy life, almost every night that you had an event on, I was busy. I had some other event on. So we planned this 9 months ago. I think we made sure, locked into the diary, that we were here tonight. And family of God, it doesn't matter what country we have come from, it doesn't matter what kind of food we eat, and I've been to many countries and eaten lots of food, and there's been countries I've been to when they've given you food and you really see grace like you have never seen grace before. You know what I mean? Like, oh God, bless this food, please look after it. If it's not dead, please kill it, you know, help it. Don't let it stay alive in here for too long. There's been places I have eaten stuff I didn't even know what it was. And so I didn't even chew it. I just swallowed it straight down. I wouldn't know. On Friday nights too, they have a Filipino group that's down the road. We value you as part of Garden City. I thank God that we don't just have a church full of Caucasians or just full of Queenslanders. We have a church from people from all different backgrounds, all different parts of the world. And to think about, you didn't choose to come to Brisbane. You didn't choose to come to Garden City. You were chosen to come to this country. You were chosen to come to Garden City. And God has planted you there for a purpose. So that through you and through your relationships, you can reach out to the generations and the cultures of Brisbane that nobody is reaching out to. Maybe because I'm an Australian, because of our culture, we can't reach out to certain people. But because where you come from and you understand their language and you understand their culture and you understand how to present Jesus in a meaningful and a relevant way to them, that we could reach out to the cultures of Brisbane. And my passion is that we would see services packed with Asians, packed with Sri Lankans, packed with Indians, packed with Nigerians, packed with Africans. I would just love to see the cultures of Brisbane reach with the gospel of Jesus Christ. And that's why I think that the meetings that you have together are more significant than you realize, that this is part of what God wants to do. He wants to bring you together. And as it says in Proverbs, that iron would sharpen iron, that from each other's lives and experiences, that you would sharpen with a precision your spiritual life. And from that, you would get a passion for your people. So that through you as a conduit, that the love and the power of Jesus might come to a city and to generations in the city and to cultures in the city that nobody else could reach. I absolutely believe for that. I just want to say from my wife and I, Fiona, we've had a really busy week. We've been out lots of nights. She's a bit tired tonight. So I brought David instead. He was happy to come. He said, what's going to be? I said, a multicultural night, so there'll be a lot of food. I'm coming! That's why he said. But just before I close, I thought what might be good is that you often hear me preach and you don't want another sermon. But I thought what might be good tonight is for you just to hear perhaps my testimony about what actually what some of the things have shaped me into the person that I am. That might just help just understand each other a bit better. I'll be really quick to them. I was at a pastor's retreat and we had a guest speaker. And this speaker said, I want you to get a piece of paper and I want you to draw two lines on the paper. Now, like, tell me about. When I was 11 years old, I went to a kids camp at Burleigh Heads. They used to have these state-run kids camps at Burleigh Heads. And I went there, and one night, the convener of the camp said, we're going to have a tarrying meeting. We're going to be praying for kids to receive the baptism of the Spirit. And I thought, well, I just don't want to go to bed. I wasn't hungry for God at that stage. I just didn't want to go to bed. So I thought, oh, well, I'll stay here for the meeting, and that way I don't have to go to bed. But I didn't really realise that that night was going to be an incredible encounter with God. And I stayed back for that meeting, and we began to seek God and seek the Holy Spirit and seek the Lord Jesus to fill us with His Spirit. And all I remember was kneeling beside that wooden pew, and something began to happen from deep within me, from way down. Inside of my being, something began to rise up and I began to sob and began to weep as the presence of God was on me, and I had no cognitive understanding of what was taking place. I couldn't understand it. All I knew was that something deeper than anything I'd ever experienced in my life was taking place inside of me, and I was filled with God's Holy Spirit as an 11-year-old kid that night. I will never forget that. Through my teenage years, when there was many temptations to go this way or to go that way or to grow cold or to grow hard, I could never forget the reality of the person and the presence of the Holy Spirit. I always knew Him, and that was the time that God called me to be a pastor. I remember going to 18. I actually proposed to my wife when she was 17. Now I have a 16-year-old daughter now. We have three kids. A son who's 17, who's at the University of Queensland studying international relations and politics, and next year will go into law. We have a daughter who is 16, she's in year 11 at the COC, and David, who turns 10 next week. He turns 10 next week. And he's... Some young boy comes to me next year and says, I want to marry your 17-year-old daughter. I'll kill him. And I look back down and think, my wife was only 17 when I proposed to her. Learning to love somebody else in the sanctity of marriage. Going through tragedy and learning to trust God and the hold of God through that, and really getting a sense of determination and breakthrough in my heart. Those things have really shaped the person that I am. So I hope that helps to give a bit of insight into the human side and of who we are. Love God, love people, love life, really love you. And I've really appreciated being here tonight. I've loved everything that I've heard here. And appreciate just the privilege of being here tonight. But what I'd love to do before we have our curry is for me just to pray for you. Pray for God's every blessing upon your life, your family, everything about you, in Jesus' name. Would you mind standing with me, please? Oh, our God, tonight, we just give you praise. I thank you that you are a good God. I thank you that you are all powerful. I thank you that you are all wise. I thank you that you are here. I thank you that you are doing a mighty work, Lord, among, Lord, the cultures of our church. I thank you, Father, for our salvation. I thank you for the cross. I thank you for the blood of Jesus. I thank you, Father, for your incredible, unfailing love for everyone that's here tonight. And Lord, in the name of Jesus, I speak and pray blessing over the lives of people that are here today. That, Lord, they would know you more deeply, they would experience you more passionately, they would walk with you more intimately, Lord, than I pray they've ever known before. I pray for people to discern and know your will with such clarity, and that they would walk in that will. I pray your blessing upon every child that is represented here, every grandchild that is represented here. I pray that you give everyone clear direction and blessing. So then, Father, in the name of Jesus, that we may please you and bring glory to you and do what you'd have us to do. I pray that, Lord, this multicultural ministry would just continue to just develop and explode and flourish, Father, in every way. I thank you for Conrad and his A team, and just pray that you would just bless them, Lord, in every way. And I thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name, for your glory. Amen. Amen. Thank you for your time. Thank you.
You may be seated. Thank you, Pastor. Thank you for the word and for sharing us your testimony. And we know.
Sorry, I'm still stuck into this attire, which is not normal. This is a sarong, which every Sri Lankan man has and wears it all the time. But this was made about 10 minutes before we got here. And I didn't have the slippers to go with, so I quickly go to the garden and take it off to the dog. Wash it quickly, I think it's not too bad. Well, another great multicultural fellowship meeting we have just seen. We have seen people from different countries, speaking different languages, having different cultures come here and perform for us, and also equally multicultural group witnessing all that, such a big crowd. It's been nearly 2 years, as Conrad mentioned earlier, and our numbers keep on increasing. And that's great. It'll be interesting to look at all these people and wonder and think about how and when these people got into the faith. Perhaps some were born into Christian homes. Others during their teen years, perhaps in school, and yet others later on in their adult life. I think even though it could be interesting to take a long time, so we'll leave that for another day. However, I'm going to tell you now how someone else became a Christian, how the bear became the Christian. Now, there was an atheist. Atheist is a person who doesn't believe in God. This atheist was very vocal. He will preach that there is no God. He will write in the newspapers. He will talk to everyone. There is no God. One day he went for a walk and he lost his way. Found himself in a jungle. Horror of horror, he saw a bear following him. The man started running, the bear started chasing him. The man ran faster, the bear ran faster. Finally, he couldn't run anymore, he just collapsed, fell on the ground. The bear caught up with him and was about to maul him, lifted his paw and was about to maul this man. Just then, this man, who never believed in God, cried loud, "Oh God!" Suddenly, the world stopped. The river which was flowing nearby stopped flowing. The wind stopped blowing. The animals which were wandering around also stopped doing what they were. And God spoke. And he talked to this man and asked him, "You who denied my existence all these years, who preached against me, how come you're calling me now? What do you want me to do?" The man felt very bad. He said, "Yes, God, I did deny your existence. I preached that you'd never existed, so I'm not going to ask a favor for me, but for the bear. Can you please make this animal a Christian?" So God said, "Yes, I'll do that." And the life came back to normal. Immediately, the bear lifted the paw from the man's body, took his other paw from the ground, put them together, bowed gracefully, and said, "Thank you, Lord, for this lovely meal. Let me eat it with a grateful heart." So that's how. I don't think our stories will be that interesting. Pastor Bruce, David, thank you very much for spending time with us. Honoring, we really appreciate. I enjoyed your message. I also like to thank a few people who have been honoring us month after month. Some pastors, Pastor Rama Rao and Dawn, every month, they're both not here today, Duke and Basanta, Neil and Quincy, Alex, and I think today we have a whole heap of other people I'm yet to know. So thank you all very much for coming to our fellowship and being a part of it.
And, as we are blessed, we bless others. And Sulo will lead us in something. While Derek passes the...
Hands with grateful heart, We thank you, Lord, that we represent the trueness of the purpose of your mission of the cross. And we ask tonight, as your people, that you will challenge us as we go to our respective calling of ministry, to be able, O Father, to be salt and light, and to be, O Father, the servants you call us to be. So bless each one here who is represented, and may, O Father, the service that has been ours tonight be an appreciation in the name of Jesus. Amen.
You will not know the song, you will not understand the song, but it talks about